traders, let's write a piece of code that will help us close some open orders. We are launching the MetaQuotes language editor and choosing from the file menu the new option. We select script and next and give a name to our new script. Now that our script has a name, we can proceed. So the script must first learn how many orders are open on the platform. For that we create a variable and we call it total, and this variable will have a value. The value will be whatever the platform will give us, interrogating the standard function. And now in the variable total we have the number of open orders at a certain moment in time. Now one by one we have to go through every one of those orders and we create a loop. And as long as there are still orders going through them from the most recent to the oldest order on the platform, we will do what we need to do with the said orders. And now in this loop that will go from the greatest number to the smallest number, we will have to select every order and close them one by one. In order to select the open order, we will have to use another standard function from the MetaTrader 4 platform. That function is order select. And we will select the order by its index. Then we specify that we need the orders to be selected from the open orders. This line then should let us select one of the orders going through all of them from the most recent to the oldest one. Now that we have an order selected, we can close the order that we've just selected, but before doing that we can check whether the operation of selecting an order was successful or not, and for that we create this condition and we will move on only if the order select function was successful. And now when this condition is met, is true, we may proceed to the operation we intend to. The operation we intend to do is to close the order, and using the order close function we can do that, specifying first the order ticket, then the order size, then the order price and so on. And here. We give the necessary parameters for the function to work. So we are closing the order with the ticket number that has the number of the selected order, with the lot size that has the same size as the selected order, and at the price, at the close price of the selected order, with a certain tolerance named slippage, so the order can still be closed even in volatile markets if the price moves quickly 1, 2, 3, and in this case 5 points. Now this line practically instructs the platform to close the order that we've just selected before. To check whether the order close function was successful or not, we have to assign the value the platform returns when we are trying to close the order. The platform will have an answer for us. It will say if the operation was successful, it will return true. If the operation was unsuccessful, it will return false. So we must read that value and store it in a variable. For that, we will create a variable, and that variable can be created at the beginning of the script, and we'll assign it the value of false by default, and it will become true only in the case when we've selected an order and we've succeeded in closing that order. And then the variable named result will become true. And in the event that the order close function is not successful, so if the result value is false, then we can print an alert on the screen, for example, and instruct the platform to take a small break in order to eventually become responsive for the connection to be restored. In this case, we'll assign a half a second pause, and let's write a message that will be printed on screen when the order close is unsuccessful. And that message could be order failed to close. Now, if we need more information about which order failed to close or why it failed to close, then this message can be further tailored in such a way that we insert in it more information. So for that, here we will place the number of the ticket, for example, and we can even read what was the platform's error when we've tried to close that order. And for that we will be using another standard function called getLastError that will return a code, and that code can be looked up in the specifications of the platform, and we will have more information about why the order wasn't closed. And now, this being a void type script function, we check whether it is it has the right number of brackets and all the loops are closed. So the beginning of the script is here and the end is here. The beginning of the loop that is going through all the orders begins here and ends here, and these conditions begins here and ends here, and this condition is causing the code to execute these two lines, and it all seems here we need to specify a value. So the variable named I is going through all the values starting from the biggest one until it reaches zero, and compiling it we have zero errors, zero warnings. Now we can move inside the platform and see whether it is working or not. This is the script we've just created, close all open orders, and let's try to see if, for example, we have a buy order here. Buy order here, sell order here, buy order here, and so on, a number of orders. We can either choose to manage them and close them manually by clicking on the X at the end of the row in the terminal window, or so we can close manually that order, or we can close all of them simply attaching the script called close all open orders to a chart. And as we see in the experts tab, the script was initialized and the orders were closed. After that, the script was removed because the code ended. And this is how we can implement a sort of panic button, and that button can be assigned to a hotkey, for example, a combination of keys, and in the event that we need to close all open orders when with a shortcut, a key shortcut, we can choose here a combination like Alt T, for example. And now that we have a combination, also key combination, let's say we have a few orders open on different currency pairs. If you want to close them all, just press the key combination we assigned and the script runs and the orders are closed. That being all, good tips and good trading.
To see more, please subscribe, give us a thumb up and share our clips.